As you saw in the previous video, it really is fun to take the baby food around the guards. But there is one more place where I enjoy smashing the Figo: the highways. This is a comprehensive review of Figo and how it feels on highways. Brace up for some good performance. The Ford Figo is a well-designed car, which is good to the eyes, except those tiny wheels. It is a typical hatchback design, mostly European here and there, and the company has not gone adventurous with the design. Let's go straight to the drive. Starting with engine performance, the car packs 100 bhp of power, has a 5-speed gearbox, and produces about 210 Nm of torque. Power is pretty brisk, and I will be showing you that real soon. Into third gear. Power fades after 4.5. 140, not a problem. The car does feel light at high speeds. For anyone who likes to drive, I think you should definitely give this car a shot to show itself. Turning on the air conditioning, it's really hot today. It's showing 35 degrees. One thing I like about the indicators specifically is you just have to tap it and it blink 3 times. That is pretty handy, and it is not a necessity, but once you're used to it, it is difficult with normal cars then. Handles well at high speeds, straight line stability is good. Not full throttle, now giving full on. Brakes work good. So the car feels relaxed at 100. After 100, it feels a bit strained. Car is doing about 2300 rpm at 100. Talking about the ride, it is good. Ride quality is good. It is supple. The faster you go, the better it is. I mean, if there are imperfections on the road, if you are going fast, you don't fall into it, even though this vehicle has small 14-inch wheels. Doing that corner was very easy, I couldn't feel a thing. So if you are going for a Ford instead of a Maruti or a Hyundai, the thing you are sure about is the handling. It is a real big jump compared to the other competitors. It feels a lot more stable and feels good. Brakes work well, but I have felt it sometimes on using the brakes too much. Once they get hot, they do fade. Plus the tires, they're only 175, so on hard acceleration, hard launches, it spins in first gear and sometimes even in second gear, because 100 bhp. Still, compared to the Figo S, the suspension is still focused to give you a more comfortable ride, other than giving you a more sporty ride. So, and one problem the car has in high speeds, it has quite a substantial amount of body roll. So talking about fuel economy, if you're not flooring the pedal all the time. If you're a bit gentle with the accelerator and doing 100 to 110 on the highway, you can easily get 22 to 23 kilometer per liter. If you go fast, if you're doing between 120 and 130, you can get about 20, still about 20, which is really good. But if you're hard on the throttle, like I was now, 17.7, decent. But if you're like, if you're doing city, if you're harsh with the accelerator, then expect the fuel economy to be around 10 to 12. And I've got 30 km per liter once, 30 kmpl. So that was when I was driving this car at between 70 to 80. So I was very gentle with the accelerator. One other thing I like about the steering wheel is how light it is. In the cities and slow moving traffic, now it got hard. If the car is still, the steering becomes very light. Now it feels heavy. It is heavy, considerably heavy. So I like the way how the engine is weighing by itself. The steering is really communicative with the wheels. You can go wherever you want. Maybe a bit too communicative, I guess, sometimes compared to the other cars I've driven. Even though this car has a very good engine, tried and tested 1.5, I particularly did not enjoy the gearbox combination they used, because in slow speeds it is a bit sluggish. The car does jerk a bit while changing gears, but you have to get used to it. And the clutch is really different compared to every other car I've driven. I don't know how to explain it, but you have to feel it for yourself. Does a decent job, but I think there could have been a better combination. When I got the car, the power was great, but the turbo was silent. Now over time, I can hear the turbo spool up. The steering got really hard now. No problem, not even full throttle. One more problem this car has when you're driving it on the highway is it has massive blind spots. The mirrors are really small, so you have a huge blind spot. I sometimes really wished if it had a 6-speed gearbox, but obviously they might have thought of it. So that is all about the Figo. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you soon.
Follow us on our Instagram at The Highway Channel and be a part of our stories. If you like our videos, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and hit that bell icon to never miss an update from us. Cheers.